In this video, we are going to see about the tree's data structure. So, what is meant by tree? A tree is a hierarchical data structure. See, this is an example of a tree where it is hierarchical. This is the topmost level. Next level is these two. Then next level is this. That is why it is called as a hierarchical structure. And this stores information. Here we store information A, B, C, and so on. So naturally, in the form of hierarchical style, we follow some order when we are storing data. So a tree looks like this. It is a hierarchical data structure. Okay, and it is a non-linear. So why we call it as a non-linear? Linear is where you store the data sequentially. That is, after one data, you access the next data. After accessing the data, you access another data, and so on. That is a strict order. So, for example, if it is an array, even if it is random, you try to, if you are going to sort, then you will be accessing next data. Then in linked list, with the next column only, the next location, you can access the next node. And its next, using that next location, you access the next node, and so on. So linear fashion only you can access the data. If you take stack, the value which is present in the top of the stack only you can access, as well as deletion. Queue you can access only from the front, and you can add only in the rear. So they follow some linear fashion. In that only you, in that case only you add data or delete data. That. So they are called non-linear data structures. Not only that, in order to access the data which is at the end of the stack, you have to pop all the elements from the stack. Same way, queue also and linear list, if you are accessing a particular data, then you have to cross all the nodes before that. So the complexity, time complexity, space increases when you go for this linear data structures. Whereas tree is a non-linear data structure. Suppose I want to access J, I can directly go from root to B and then E and then J. So like this. But if you try to store this as a linear linked list, then you will be storing A, B, C, D, etc., etc. And you have to go all these things, even D, H, I, E, all these things in order to reach the J element. So if you see that, you will be crossing all these elements. You will be going through all these elements in order to get J if you are trying to store this as a linear list. Whereas here it is not that. I want to access J means 1, 2, 3, 4th access itself, I will get the data. So likewise, it reduces the time complexity. When you try to store any data in a tree structure, it will reduce the time complexity, and this will be vastly used in our database structures and file system management, where we use folders. Recent access will come. So for example, I am accessing a folder just now, that will come as the first one so that I can go into it and access not only recent. So these things are followed in that can be implemented using a tree structure. So a tree is a non-linear hierarchical data structure that consists of nodes connected by edge. So here it's a non-linear. After this only you have to access after A, B, then C, then D, then E. It's not like that. You can so that is why it is called a non-linear hierarchical data structure. You can directly go to the respective node just by following the path. That's all. And there are these things. If the value is present, that is said to be a node. So this is a node, this is a node, this is a node. Inside that you store the values. Those two nodes, they are connected by edges. Okay. So this is said to be edge. And here, these are all said to be levels. This is at the level 0, this is at level 1, 2, 3, and so on. And parent node. This is the very first element at the top of the that is at level 0 is said to be root. So there will be only one root for any tree. Then there will be many parents. So this also is called as a parent for these two. These are all the children of this root. And so this is a parent of these two. This is a parent of these two. And this is the child node of D, and so on. So these are all the terminology which you are using. And if you this can be called as a subtree. So this can be called as a subtree of A. This can be called as a subtree of A. And the one which does not have child, they are said to be leaf nodes. So node, each data item in a tree is referred as node. So each data item where we store the data, this is said to be a node. So edge, this represents the connection between the two nodes. This is called edge. Then root, the node at the top of the tree is called the root. Path, path refers to the sequence of nodes along the edges of a tree. Parent, so what is path? If I want to go to J, then you have to move from A to B, B to E, E to J. This is said to be path, and a path will be unique for a particular node. So parent, any node except the root node has one edge upward to a node called parent. So child is the node below a given node connected by its edge downward is called its child node. So when it is connected downward, here this is said to be a child node of that. Then leaf, the node which does not have any child is called. So this is the node which does not have any child. H does not have any child. I don't have any child. So these are all said to be H, I, J, F, G. All these things are said to be leaf nodes. Whereas these two are said to be sibling. What do you mean by sibling? If they have the same parent, then they are said to be siblings. Then subtree. Subtree represent the descendants of a node. So for this is a node means this parent. These things will be subtree. So this is a subtree of this parent. This is a subtree of this parent. These things will be a subtree of A. Visiting. Visiting refers to checking the value of a node when control is on the node. Now when you visit this, you read this value. When you move from here to here, you read this value. This is said to be visiting that node and see what is stored in that particular node. Then traversing. Traversing means passing through nodes in a specific order. I want to traverse. Okay, traverse the all the values in the tree. So there are some logic involved. There are some conditions involved that we will see later. That is pre-order, post-order and in-order. That we will see later. First, we will see what the terminology of a tree. So levels. Levels of a node represent the generation of a node. If the root node is at level 0, then its next child node is at level 1, grandchild at level 2 and so on. That is what I have given here. Level 0, level 1, level 2 and level 3. Degree of a node is equal to the number of children a node gap. For example, for this, degree of this node is 2. It has 2 children. Degree of this node is 1 because it has only 1 children. Degree of this node is 2 because it has only 2 children. So direct children only it will connect, not the grandchildren. Then height. Height is the number of levels. This has how many levels? It has 4 levels. So the height is said to be let us leave the level 0. So it has 3 levels. So height of the tree is said to be 3. Now this is an example. See here. It is 0, 1. It has given from here. Height. For this, there is no height. Okay, this is starting. So height is 0. Then it has one thing. So it is height 1, height 2 and height 3. So this, the one which has the 4 levels, it is said to be a tree with a height of 3. And depth. Depth you start from here. 0, this is 1, 2, 3, reverse of height. Then these are all the some of the explanation for the tree. This is a root and the value which is stored is called to be key. And this is the edge, the one which is connected to nodes is said to be edge. And these are siblings, as I said already. They are the child of a particular parent. They are said to be siblings. And this is a subtree and this is a parent of this. And these are all the children's. The degree, if you take degree of this, it has 3 child children. So the degree of this node is 3 and these are all the leaf nodes because they don't have further children. So they are said to be leaf nodes and this is the height of the tree. These are all just some examples. How will you calculate the degree of a tree? So A and A, for A it is 3. Since it is 3 children, so it is. For D also it is 3. So 3. 3 children. So it is degree is 3. For B it has 2 and for G it has 2. So 2 children. For C, it is only 1 children and E also only 1 children. So, they come under the degree is 1. For all the K, F, L, K, F, L, M, H, I, J, they don't have children. So, the degree is equal to 0. And what is the degree of the tree? Here, we have represented each, the degree of each node. If you take degree of the tree, then you have to take the maximum value, maximum degree. If you see that maximum degree is 3, so that you can take it as a degree of the tree. Then path. Path includes all the nodes and edges, not just edges. So when we path from A to K, here includes A to B, B to E, E to K, including the traveling edges. Same way, here if you say A to D, then path, direction of the path is strictly from top to bottom. Always it moves from there, not from bottom to upwards. Always travel from root or any parent to children only. Not from children to parent, it will not move. Then height. Already we have seen height. So here height of this tree is 3 because level 1, level it is 0, 1, 2, 3. So the height is 3 and B and C, these are all 2. And these are all at level, height is 1. For all these things, the level height is 0. Then subtree, as we have seen, this is a subtree for this. This is a subtree for A and so on. So why a tree data structure? Why we need this? The data structure such as arrays, linked lists, stack and queues or linear data structure that store data sequentially. In order to perform any operation in linear data structure, the time complexity increases with the increase in the data set, because when you have 100 linked list data or 1000, then I want to access the 1000th data, then you have to pass on all the 999 data in order to reach the 1000. It takes so much of time to reach the data. So that's what I mean by time complexity. This is not acceptable in today's computation because voluminous data is there. In that case, if you access the middle element, even the middle element will be in the millionth place. So in order to access that, you need lot of time. So which is not acceptable in today's computational world. So you have to increase the speed. The different tree data that comes handy. They allow quicker and easier access to the data as it is a non-linear data structures. Some of the applications we will see. Application of a tree. Here, this is a given the Linux kernel system, that is folder system of Linux. So for example, this is a root and these are all the directories. After this root, these are all the directories. Then after this, this directory has some more children of that, some more folders. So if you say that this looks like a tree structure, so this tree structure can be implemented for the folder. So a file system is an application of a tree. One can follow your path from the root here, from the root to anything. So I want to access MySQL means I can go from here, here, here. Whereas if you have a linear data structure, I have to search for that to reach. Whereas in tree access itself, I can go there. That is the main advantage of that, it's fast. So another important property of a tree is one can move a subtree. Suppose I want to move this subtree, etc. under the user, I can directly move without disturbing the path from etc to there. So I can directly move from here and attach it. So only thing is slash etc. Then here post px instead, I have to give slash user and then etc. and then this. So here, for example, the entire subtree starting with etc. can be moved from root and reattach under slash user. This would change the unique path name of HTTPD. That is like this HTTPD from etc. HTTP to user etc. That's all. It will not affect the content or any children of the HTTP directory. So that is the main advantage of having a tree structure. Another example in our web pages. When you click a link, it keeps going to another link. When you click that, it moves to the other. So that itself is a tree structure. So here, let us take this, how we can represent it as a tree structure, how it is a tree structure that we will see. So here HTML, that is at the root. Then under that we have head, and then within that we have body. So that is given here. So within that head we have meta and title, and within that body we have this UL, H1, H2, etc. And within UL we have this LI, etc. So this can be represented. So this is one of the application of a tree. So a web page itself is an implementation so that you can access a particular data very fast. If I want to access this, I can go from here to here, here, instead of going here. So this is a great advantage, one of the application of a tree.